changed. You remain the same. Everlasting God, you reign. Alpha, Omega, beginning and the end. That's just who you are.
Same. Everlasting God, you reign. Alpha, Omega, beginning and the end. That's just who you are.
Change. You remain by Jehovah to be my Ebenezer. It means God is my helper. And that's what we are saying this morning. That Jehovah, you are indeed our helper. Jehovah, my Ebenezer.
Jehovah is my Ebenezer. Jehovah is my Ebenezer.
He is my Ebenezer.
Jehovah is my Ebenezer. Jehovah is my Ebenezer.
You are my Ebenezer.
Jehovah is my Ebenezer. Jehovah is my Ebenezer.
Jehovah is my Ebenezer. Jehovah is our Ebenezer. He's our Ebenezer.
Jehovah is my Ebenezer. Jehovah is my Ebenezer.
Dwelling place, Lord, a palace of your praise, beneath the banner of your grace.
Let me be your dwelling place, Lord, a palace of your praise, beneath the banner of your grace. Dwelling place, Lord, the banner of your grace, beneath the banner of your grace.
Let me be your dwelling place.
Let me be your dwelling place, Lord, the banner.
Of your praise beneath the banner of your your grace.
Let me be your dwelling place, Lord, a palace of your grace, beneath the banner of your grace.
Let me be your dwelling place.
Let me be your dwelling place,
a palace of your praise.
Lord, a palace of your grace.
Let me be your dwelling place, Lord, a palace of your praise, beneath the banner of your grace. I'll sing it again. Let me be your dwelling place, Lord, a palace of your praise, beneath the banner of your grace. Let me be your dwelling place.
Let me be your dwelling place.
A palace of your praise.
Lord, a palace of your praise.
God.
Beneath the banner of your grace.
Let me be your dwelling place, oh God.
Let me be your dwelling place.
A palace of your praise. God is indeed worthy of honor, he's worthy of glory, and he's worthy of praise. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Worthy of honor and worthy of glory and worthy of praise is he. Worthy of honor and worthy of glory and worthy of praise is he. He has redeemed us by the blood of the Lamb. He set our spirit free.
By the blood of the Lamb, sets our spirit free. Worthy of glory and worthy of honor and worthy of praise is he. Worthy of glory and worthy of honor and worthy of praise is he.
My Lord is worthy of glory, is worthy of honor, worthy of praise is he. Worthy of honor and worthy of glory and worthy of praise is he. Has redeemed us by the blood of the Lamb. Set our spirit free. Worthy of glory and worthy of honor and worthy of praises. Worthy of glory and worthy of honor and worthy of praises. Worthy of honor.
Worthy of honor and worthy of glory and worthy of praises.
It's worthy.
Worthy of glory and worthy of glory and worthy.
Worthy of of glory and worthy of praise is he. He has redeemed us by the blood of the Lamb. He set our spirit free. Worthy of honor and worthy of glory and worthy of praise is he. Worthy of honor and worthy of glory and worthy of praise is he.
Worthy of honor and worthy of glory and worthy of praise is he.
He's worthy, 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 worthy,
worthy of praise is he.
He has redeemed
us. He has redeemed us by the blood of the Lamb and set our spirit free. Worthy of glory and worthy of honor and worthy of praise is he. Worthy of glory.
Give you the highest praise, for you are worthy to be lifted up. We give you the highest praise, for you are worthy to be lifted up.
Give you the highest praise, for you are worthy to be lifted up. We give you the highest praise, for you are worthy to be lifted up.
We give you the highest praise, for you are worthy to be lifted up. We give you the highest praise. Lord, you are worthy to be lifted up.
We give you the highest praise. For you are worthy to be lifted up. We give you the highest praise. For you are worthy to be lifted up. Bye. It's already done.
My eyes may not see it. By faith I receive it.
It will manifest. It's already done.
For the things that you have done, and the battles you have won. For the things that you have done, and the battles you have won. Only you are worthy of our praise. We magnify your name. Only you are worthy of our praise. We magnify your name.
For the things that you have done,
and the
battles you have won.
For
the things that you have done,
and
the battles you have won.
Only you
are worthy of our praise. We magnify your name.
Only you
are worthy of our praise. We magnify your name.
Oh Lord, we magnify your name. And the battles you have won. For the things that you have done, and the battles you have won. Only you are worthy of our praise. We magnify your name. Only you are worthy of our praise. We magnify your name. Oh, oh Lord, we magnify your name. Oh Lord, we magnify your name. Oh Lord,
oh Lord, we magnify your name. Oh Lord, we magnify your name.
The Lord reigns. The Lord reigns. The Lord reigns.
Wash
my sins away.
Oh, happy day.
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 happy day.
Oh, happy day.
Oh, happy day.
Morning, I will be speaking on the topic that says the benefits of thanksgiving. The benefits of thanksgiving. Our Bible passage was taken from the book of 107, that the passage that was read to us earlier on. 107, verse 1 to 9. Verse 8 of it says, "Oh, that men will praise the Lord." Brethren, there is a saying in my mother's tongue, that is, if a child knows how to say thank you for the gift that was given to him or her yesterday, he or she will be able to receive more. David realized this. That's why he says in verse 8 of that Psalm 107, verse 8, he says, "Oh, that man will praise the Lord for his goodness and for his wondrous work, for what he has been doing in our lives." He said, "Oh, that man who praise the Lord. Oh, that man who praise the Lord for his goodness and for his wonderful works to the children of men, to the children of men. For his goodness and for his wonderful works to the children of men, to the children of men. He has broken the gates of brass and caused the bars of iron and sunder. He has broken the gates of brass and caused the bars of iron and sunder. Oh, that man will praise the Lord. Oh, that man will praise the Lord for his goodness and for his wonderful works to the children of men, to the children of men. He has broken the gate of brass and cut the bars of iron asunder. He has broken the gate of brass and cut the bars of iron asunder." So I want you to personalize it like this. Oh, that man who praise the Lord. Oh, that man who praise the Lord for his goodness and for his wonderful works to somebody like me, to somebody like me. He has broken the gate of brass and cut the bars of iron asunder. He has broken the gate of brass and cut the bars of iron asunder. Oh, that man, oh, praise the Lord. Oh, that man who praise the Lord for his goodness and for his wonderful works to somebody like me, to somebody like me. He has broken the gate of brass and cut the bars of fire and sunder.
He has broken the gate of brass
and cut the bars of fire and sunder. Brethren, the Almighty God, he has caught the gate of brass. That is why you are here today. All the bars of iron that the enemies, they are telling you that they will not let you go, the Almighty God, they have caught them. That is why you are able to be a living soul this morning. Brethren, if you realize the goodness and the wonderful works that the Almighty God is doing in your life, in your family, in your ministry, in your career, you will know that it deserves all the honor. Our Almighty God deserves all the glory. He deserves all the adorations. Think of it from January up to date. Who has been granting you the miracle of sleeping and waking? Think of it. From January up to date, who has been promoting you in your place of work? Think of it. The strength, the energy that you are using day in, day out. You don't want to go late to church, to work. Who has given you that strength? It is God. Brethren, this God deserves all the glory. You cannot thank him enough. You cannot appreciate him enough if you know what he has been doing in your life. For his provisions, for his preservation in your lives and your family. You need to give him quality thanks. You need to give him quality thanks and know it fully. Even what you have been asking God, maybe he has not done it for you. You know that you can praise him in advance. You can sow it as a seed into the life of God and say, yes, God, this is my dancing. I'm sowing it as a seed because I want it to germinate. Brethren, this morning, I don't want to know the art of heaviness that have come with you into this auditorium today. I want you to display it. I want you to show forth the praises of him that has called you from the darkness unto his marvelous light. It is not by your power that you are alive today. It is not by my power that I'm alive today. Many of our mates, they have passed beyond. It's not because these people, their own sins are so terrible that they cannot be forgiven. But it's just because of the mercies of God over your life. It's just because of the mercies of God over my life. I'm here this morning. It is not by my own power. It is not by my own doings. I don't know how to do it. It's this God that has been my backing. And somebody that has been backing you, that has not allowed you to be backward. Why don't you not open your mouth and give thanks unto him? Knowing fully that you are not doing it in vain, there is a reward in doing so. And I pray the Almighty God will reward us abundantly this morning in the mighty name of Jesus. So, I'll be mentioning the point now, the benefits of thanksgiving. One of the benefits of thanksgiving is divine presence of God. Divine presence of God. In the book of Psalm 22, Almighty God. All right. It's not in the pleasure of the Almighty God for us not to make our ways right before the Almighty God. But thou art holy, O thou that inhabits the praises of Israel. That is what I want. So he said, but thou art holy, O thou that inhabits the praises of Israel. That is, when you are praising the Almighty God will dwell in your place. He will inhabit your places. He will abide in your life. He will continue to dwell with you. He will continue to live by you. He will continue to live with you. But if you continue to murmur, if you continue to grumble, if you continue to nag, it will create distance between you and the Almighty God. If you want God to inhabit your places, it is for you to begin to worship God. It is for you to give him quality worship. It is for you to begin to give thanks unto him. If you want him to come and abide in your place, if you want him to inhabit in the place of your work, if you want him to inhabit in the life of your children, it is for you to begin to render praises concerning these children. I don't know the obstacles that you are facing concerning your children. When you start praising God concerning them, that I know this, I'm facing these challenges concerning this, my particular son, but I've offered this son unto you, and I'm praising you ahead concerning him because I know through my praises you will change his life for better. Then it means that you want God to inhabit the life of that your son. So if you want divine presence of the Almighty God to abide with you, it is better for us to always give thanks unto the King of Kings, unto the Almighty God, the one that inhabits the praises of his people. The book of Psalm 100, verse 4 says that we should enter his gates with thanksgiving, enter his courts with praise. We should always enter his gates, always allow. You can also create gates, the gate of God, in your own personal individual houses. By doing what? By praising him. By giving him thanks. by giving him thanks. That's by so doing, you are inviting the presence of the Almighty God. Psalm 100, verse 4. It says, enter into his gate with thanksgiving and into his court with praise. Be thankful unto him and bless his name. It's not only when you come and gather with the saints of God in the church that you can create gates of God in for yourself. You can create gates of God even in your own personal room by praising him, by giving him thanks, by singing unto him, by worshiping him. By so doing, you are inviting the presence of the Almighty God. One of the blessings is this divine presence will always abide when you are praising him. Even when you are praising him in your toilet, the presence, the divine presence, will always abide in there. When you are praising him in your car, the divine presence will always abide there. So this morning, for us to experience the divine presence of the Almighty God, we need to give him quality times at all times. It does not matter wherever we find ourselves. We remember the story of these people that they were embarking on the journey, and the mother was telling the son, invite Jesus Christ into your car. And they said the old car were full. Nobody, you can't contain anybody. All right, this old woman put a crate of egg in the trunk, and before they knew it, they traveled and there was an accident. Because of the divine presence of God that surrounds the egg, none of the egg got broken. But all the living souls inside the car, they were dead. Because they did not allow divine presence to go with them. Brethren, this morning, as you cultivate the habit of giving thanks unto the King of Kings, unto the Lord of Lords, you are inviting his presence. And I pray that his presence will continually abide with us in the name of Jesus. Another benefit that you can derive in giving thanks or in praising or in worshiping God is there will be deliverance from all fears. Psalm 34, verse 4. There will be deliverance from all fears. Psalm 34, verse 4, it says, I sought the Lord, and he heard me, and delivered me from all my fears. I sought the Lord, and he delivered me from all my fears. So when you are giving thanks unto that, I don't know, that situation that enemy has enlarged, that make you to be fearful. Brethren, do you know that you can be fearless through praising God? You can be the person that will be bold as lion through giving him quality worship. The Almighty God can deliver you from the fears of that unknown through giving him quality worship. So God wants you to be bold as lion. He wants you to have peace. He doesn't want you to be afraid of any situation. He doesn't want you to be fidgeting in any case. He doesn't want you to be afraid of any circumstances. What he wants from you is just give me this thanks. Because this is the only thing that the Almighty God cannot do for himself. He can do anything. He can kill. He can make alive. He can create. He can destroy. But one thing that the Almighty God cannot do for himself is that he cannot worship himself. He cannot praise himself. And we, the individuals that the Almighty God has now created in his own image, what is that thing that will now prevent us from worshiping him? If the trees in the bushes, they are praising him by waving their branches. If the fishes in the oceans, they can praise God, even the way they are swimming all over. What? How much more? You that God created in his own image. They are not the image of God, and they are still giving thanks unto him. What will now be your complaining? What will be your murmuring? What will be the reason for your murmuring? What will be the reason for your nagging that will not allow you to open your mouth and say, Father, I thank you? Brethren, this morning, God wants us to move forward. He wants to dwell in our place. He wants to deliver us from all forms of fears. Therefore, I'm just encouraging us this morning. If you have not created that habit of giving him thanks, start from today. It is not too late. Start from today. God is here. He will deliver you from all your fears. And I pray as we dance and as we clap our hands unto the Almighty God this morning, the Father will deliver every one of us from all our fears in the mighty name of Jesus. Another blessings that you can receive from giving thanks is blessing of multiplications. Blessings of multiplications. This can be seen in the book of Mark 8:6-9. I will not read it because of our time. I've just summarized the story. The people, they were in the multitude, they were in the wilderness, and there was no food for them to eat. And Jesus Christ had compassion upon these people. He doesn't want to send them away because he doesn't want anybody to get fainted on the way. He called upon the disciples. Do we have anything? He said, among this multitude, how many loaves of bread can we even get to supply all these people? How many fishes can we even have to supply to meet the need of these people? Because they forgot who they were with. Jesus Christ said, whatever, the little that one that you have, bring them. They brought 7 loaves of bread. And what did Jesus Christ do? He prayed, he gave thanks unto the Almighty God. And immediately he said, begin to share, begin to distribute. Allow these people to sit down and begin to share it. Before you know it, 7 loaves of bread fed 4,000 men. It fed 4,000 men, and they were fragments. They were remnants at the end of the day. They have 7 loaves of bread and small fishes. And through thanksgiving, there was multiplications. So I don't know that what you are longing for, brethren. I don't know what your heart is desiring this time around. Why can't you cultivate this habit? Why can't you? Maybe you have been praying on a particular issue, and it seems there was nothing. No solution to this. But brethren, you can pray amiss, but you can't praise God amiss. Because that is his own food. That is what he wants from you. He's not happy when you are frowning your face and you are murmuring and you are complaining and you are nagging. He's not happy with that. But when you are joyful, even in that situation that seems is impossible, when you are joyful and you are rejoicing over that situation, the Almighty God will be smiling with you. He will be laughing at you and say, yes, my son, he knows the clue. He has gotten this thing. He knows the reason. He knows the way to his breakthroughs. So, my brethren, this morning, I'm just encouraging every one of us that if you want more multiplications in our careers, in our finances, let us turn into prayer. In verse 9 of the Bible passage that we read, it says, he sanctified the longing souls. That is, whatsoever that your heart desire, he is going to meet it. He's going to give unto you what your heart desires. But you can't receive it when you are murmuring. You cannot receive that when you are nagging. When you are complaining, no, it is impossible for you to get it. But when you are joyful, you know that, yes, you are rejoicing over that situation, over that impossible things. Then you now say, yes, I will now arise and step into this situation. This morning, brethren, as we will continue to praise the Almighty God, for the rest of this year, I want you to just cultivate this habit. Even that particular issue that seems impossible, or the doctors, they have told you that there is no solution to it, why don't you burst into praises? Tell the Almighty God that created you, the one that can make provisions, the one that can, the way, he is the way. He is only the way that can make way where there is no way. Brethren, the only one that can turn impossibility to possible. The only one that can reverse the irreversible. We were listening to the Holy Ghost night on Friday, and a woman gave testimony. Somebody of 53 years. To us now, we will believe that it is impossible for her to give birth. At 53 years of age, this woman gave birth, and she brought this child. Somebody that has no fallopian tube for so many years, she prayed unto God. So many people, they have diagnosed that there's no way. She even told us so many things that she has went through, went to Baba, the Obia's people. So many things that they ask her to do, but nothing happens. But the Almighty God did it for her. She said, if God can do this for me, I'm going to return this child unto him. And the child is now 20 years, and he brought the child back unto God. Brethren, that is what God can do in your life. We don't know that situation that seems impossible in your life. The Almighty God will turn them around for better this moment in the mighty name of Jesus. And Daddy Joe also told us that, he told us his own story, that among in his town, everybody, they know that his family is one of the family, or one of the family that were so poor. They were so poor that even the poor were referring to his father as a poor man. He doesn't have money at all. And with the, without this money too, this man married to two wives. Daddy Joe happened to be the last born of the family. So, but because the mother of Daddy Joe understand the rules behind multiplications. So when they're about, the school, the children, they're about to resume like this, as our children is about to resume school like this. Mommy Gio, the mother of Daddy Gio, we just go to Daddy Gio and begin to praise him. And begin to praise him. You can do this. You can, even when she realizes that she cannot even do it. You can do this. You have been doing this before. He will start begin to praise him in our own dialect. And the man's head will swell up and say, all right, woman, what do you want? What do you want from me? And he say, it's because of your son, because of the school fees. The man will say, forget about it. Even if I don't have, I go and borrow. That is God for you. If you start praising God, you make the head of God swell. If you start praising God, you want God to step into that situation of your life that seems impossible. Brethren, let us cultivate this habit of giving thanks unto the Almighty God. Another blessing that thanksgiving can deliver into our hands is the thanksgiving will make us to succeed without sweat. Thanksgiving will make us to succeed without sweat. I want us to open our Bible to the book of Isaiah 65, 6. Isaiah chapter 65, verse 6. Isaiah chapter 65, verse 6. It says, behold, it is written before me. I will not keep silence, but will recompense into their bosom. The Almighty God will not keep silent concerning your case. When you start giving him quality worships, when you start praising him, he will not keep quiet because you don't want him to keep quiet. That is why you are praising him. That is why you are opening your mouth, because a closed mouth is a closed destiny. And you don't want your destiny to be closed. That is why you are giving quality thanks unto the Almighty God. He will arise. He said, I will not keep quiet. I will not be silent. That issue, I don't know that is issue that is giving you concerns. If you don't want God to be silent over that issue, why don't you open your mouth and begin to give him quality praises? Why don't you open your mouth and begin to worship God? Even where people, there is no people to even see you. In your own closet, why don't you open your mouth and begin to give him quality praises? Brethren, the Almighty God will give you success without sweat. He gave Jehoshaphat success without sweat. He just continue thanking me. Just continue worshiping me. Just continue praising me. And at the end of the day, overwhelming victory. That's the next blessing. Overwhelming victory. It happens in the life of Jehoshaphat. When the three countries, they arose and they are ready to destroy the land of Israel. But this man realized that even if, come talk of it, if I should go and face these people in battle, I can't prevail. Where is that strength that will make me to prevail? So you went to the man of God. What should I do? In this case, you are the only one that can save me. You are the only one that can deliver me. And God says, don't worry. Just leave this battle for me. This battle alone is for me. I want to be glorified. Just leave it for me. Just, all what you need to do is just be worshiping me. Can you imagine? If somebody now is about to face a war, and you instruct the person to go and be worshiping God, that it seems foolish before human beings, but that is the only way that they can succeed. That is the only way that they can overcome these people. That is the only way that God will give them victory. Brethren, what is that problem in your lives? The problem that has weighed you down. The problem that the people of the world have been telling you that there will not be solution to it. Brethren, why don't you create that habit of giving this God quality thanks so that he can make way for you where there is no ways? So that he can create paths even between the oceans. Can you imagine? In the life of Israelites, he created paths, he created way, even in the midst of the ocean like this. And the children of Israel, they walk on a dry land. That is God for you. That is God, his almightiness. He's showing his almightiness. That situation that you find yourself, God is ready to show his almightiness in that situation. That God is ready to show his power in that situation that you find yourself. Why don't you turn it to praises? Why don't you cultivate this habit of giving thanks unto him so that he can deliver unto you overwhelming blessings? The Bible recorded that even 3 days after the battle was over, Israelites, they started packing everything that these people have lost. Brethren, that is what God can do for us. He can multiply our blessings. He can stay by us. He can make our habitation to be his own dwelling by praising him. He can take away every form of fears from our lives. I don't know that fears of unknown that is battling with. The Almighty God is ready to step into that situation, but he needs something from you. That is praising him. He wants you to do something for him. What he cannot do for himself, that is worshiping him. I pray the Almighty God will grant unto every one of us overwhelming victory today in the mighty name of Jesus. Another blessings that you can derive from praising God or giving thanks unto God is destruction of yokes and bondages. Destructions of yokes and bondages. It happens in the life of Paul and Silas. They were in the prisons. They put them into the prisons. And they realized that, yes, in this prison that we are, nobody can take us away from this prison. Except the Almighty God, except if God intervened. So they started using this tool, the tool of giving thanks unto God, the tool of praising God. Even in the midst, when they were in bondage, when their hands and their feet were tied down, they started using this vessel, these tools of giving thanks unto the Almighty God. If you have changed our hand, you have changed our leg, but you have not changed our mouth. We can still use our mouth to praise God. Even while we were chained, we can still move around to the left, to the right, and praise God. They cultivated this habit, and God said, wow, even in this midst of your being imprisoned, you can still open your mouth and give thanks unto me. Brethren, while you are still living, God is expecting you to give thanks unto him. While you are still living, he wants you to open your mouth and give thanks unto him so that he can set you loose from that bondage, from that yoke of barrenness, that yoke of fruitlessness, that yoke of ill-luck that the enemy has placed upon you. God is ready to set you loose. God is ready to loose you out of these yokes. He is ready to free you from that bondage that the enemy has put you into. Cultivate that habit today. Try God. Make a try and say, God, they have been saying it. It's that it works. It works faster than medications. Praising God works faster than medications. What the doctors, they cannot even diagnose. Talk less of prescribing to treat the such ailments. But the Almighty God can prescribe for you. And what is prescribing for you is open your mouth and praise me. That is the prescription that he's giving you this morning. Open your mouth and praise me. Just open your mouth and give me quality thanks. Just open your mouth and worship me. I'm ready to step into the situation. And I pray the Almighty God will set every one of us loose today in the name of Jesus. Another blessing that we can derive from giving thanks unto God is blessing of perfection. Blessing of perfection. It happens in the life of 10 lepers in the book of Luke 17, 12 to 19. 10 lepers, they were begging Jesus, heal us, have mercy upon us. And God said, oh, go ahead. And as they were going, they discovered that that they are being cleansed. All right. One of them said, my skin was not like this before. I need to go back to the person that told me to do this. And he went back. And the Almighty God made him whole. He perfected that healing. He perfected that healing. Is it the breakthrough that you want God to perfect in your lives? Is it your finances that you want God to perfect in your lives? Is it your healing that you want God to perfect in your lives? Why don't you turn it to praises? Why don't you turn that situation to thanksgiving? Why don't you begin to worship the Almighty God so that he can perfect everything that concerns you? Brethren, this morning, as we are about to dance, as we are about to practicalize it, I want you to make up your mind. Although I've not been dancing before, although I've not been opening my mouth to give thanks unto God before, but this morning, I've heard about it, and I want to try God. I want to test him. I want to put him to test so that he can perfect everything that concerns me. I pray the Almighty God will perfect everything that concerns us this morning in the mighty name of Jesus. Brethren, when we are blessed, when we are giving thanks unto God, do we realize that we are fulfilling the commandments of God? And there is a joy in that, in fulfilling the commandment of God. In 1 Thessalonians 5:18, he said, in everything, give thanks unto the Lord. For this is the will of God in Christ Jesus concerning us. It is the will of God for us to begin to give thanks unto him. Then, and as we are giving thanks unto him, we will have this joy that, yes, I'm in the midst of fulfilling the commandment or commandment of God. Therefore, everything that I will lay my hand upon, I shall prosper. I shall prosper because there is nobody that will be in the center will of God that will be backward. There is nobody that will be in the center will of God that will experience failure. David realized that. That is why he was being referred to as an addicted thanksgiver. An addicted thanksgiver. And God himself said, this is the man out of my own heart. God loves him. He loves him. Do you want God to love you too? Do you want God to always abide with you? Do you want God to take away every form of fears in your life? Do you want God to set you loose from every bondages? Do you want God to give you overwhelming victory? Do you want God to multiply that which, that little that you had? Do you want God to give you a success without sweat? Brethren, you need to cultivate the habit of giving thanks unto the Almighty God. Finally, when you give thanks unto the Almighty God, he will bless you with divine surprises and miracles. Divine surprises and miracles. It happens in the life of Lazarus. In the book of John 11, 41 to 44. John 11, 41 to 44. When Jesus Christ was informed that Lazarus was dead. Even by the time Jesus Christ got there, the sister was saying, no, I know that this person has been dead for 4 days. And there's no way he can resurrect again. And the Almighty God told them that yes, he will resurrect. Even now, I'm not talking about the future resurrection. I'm talking at the resurrection that will happen now. That this man will resurrect. And what did Jesus Christ do? He told God that, Father, I thank you because you always answered me. He said, Father, I thank you because I know you are always answering me. And before he finished the prayer, before giving the thanks finished, he told Lazarus, come forth. And somebody that was buried, somebody that was wrapped with graveyard cloths, came forth. Brethren, what is that thing in your life that is already dead? I don't know that situation. The doctor said there's no way they can live again. The dry bone can live again. This is the good news that I'm here to tell you this morning, that the dry bone can still live again. The dry bone in your businesses, the dry bone concerning your health, the dry bone over your career, the dry bone over your children, the dry bone concerning your health, the dry bone in your finances, the dry bone concerning your ministry. Brethren, I'm here to inform you that they can still live again, because it has happened before. And God is the same. Jesus Christ is the same yesterday, today, and forever. He changeth not. He faileth not. He just wants us to pay our own role. He just wants us to do our own role. He just wants us to do as he ordered us. That is, just praise me. In that situation that you find yourself that seems difficult before you, praise me ahead and see and whether I will not step into it. As he commanded us that we should bring our tithe and offering, that when we would bring our tithe and offering, that is going to open the doors of heaven, that we will not have enough room to even to contain it. So also he's commanding us that open your mouth, my daughter. Open your mouth, my son. Give me quality worship. I'm ready to step into this situation. Brethren, let us not make ourselves to have a closed mouth towards that situation that we are facing. Let us be ready to open our mouth wide. Let us be ready to use our hands to clap when it is time to clap. Let us be ready to move our body to the left and to the right to give thanks unto the Almighty God. Because of what? We don't want to remain the same. Anybody that gives thanks, anybody that worships God, anybody that gives quality worship unto God, we never remain the same. That leper was never remained the same. Others, they were like that, they were the same. But he knew that, yes, somebody did this thing for me. I didn't do it like this. My skin were not like this before. So I need to go back and give thanks unto that person. So brethren, why won't you now give thanks unto the person that has been giving you your protection since January up to this present moment? You have been experiencing miracle of sleeping and waking. Brethren, do you think it's just for fun? It's not for fun. God knows what he wants for your life. That is why he has spared your life to see another day like this. That is where he has given you good health. That is where he has given you good mind. That is where he has given you sound mind. Many people, they cannot reason of themselves. You have to reason for them. But you are not among these people. Brethren, we are not making yes upon these people, but I just want you to realize the goodness and the wonderful works that the Almighty God is doing in your life. Brethren, from today onward, let us stop complaining.
I need some praise and praises.